Hey guys, my name is Jackie. Welcome to The Bite. Today we're going to be making my tuna salad that I love. I'm honestly not even a fan of tuna salad, but if you've seen me on Instagram, you've seen me post this probably 2-3 times, which is surprising because normally tuna salads are filled with mayo, but the one that I have here is filled with lots of vegetables, lots of crunch, and very minimal mayo actually. So let's get into the ingredients so I can show you what's in it.
I have here 4 cans of tuna. This is solid tuna, solid white tuna in water that I've drained, and I've kind of just chopped it up with my spoon a little bit. Some carrots and celery that I finely chopped. The carrots are peeled, and I'll show you what I'm gonna do with these in just a second. A little bit of mayo, a little bit of sweet relish, some salt and pepper, and I have a couple ingredients that I'll use just to finish it off, and I will show you that when we get there. But first, the carrots and celery. What I like to do with these is put them in a mini food processor that I have back here. I just like to finely grate them almost. It just does the job much quicker than I could with a knife. So I'm gonna chop my carrots first, then my celery, because I find that the carrots kind of stain my food processor a little bit orange, and the celery kind of helps to wipe that orange right off. So I'm gonna do that and then we'll come right back.
So I've grated my carrots and my celery, and it's very, very fine. And as you can see, it would have taken me a long time to do this by hand. So grated that, and then I grated my celery. For the celery, you know, it's mainly water, so I drained out all that water. I did it by hand because it's just my husband and I eating this, but if you want to do it in a strainer or a sieve, however you say it, you could do that as well. So just gonna mix this up, and this is gonna make the tuna such a really pretty color.
So I've gotten this mixed up pretty well.
I normally don't like super mayo-based tuna salads, and that's kind of why I'm just not a fan of tuna to begin with. But you know, you need a tiny bit to bind it all together, and it helps it mix pretty well too. But this is only like a quarter cup of mayo, and it's not gonna be a super like white-based tuna. So that's why I really enjoy this, is because I mainly get the flavor of the vegetables. So I add that in, give that a good mix, and I'm gonna add my relish as well. The relish makes this. It makes this whole thing. It just does. When you try it, you'll know. So this is essentially done. The last thing I like to do is to just kind of add that little pop of flavor from some salt and pepper. And pepper. And I like to chop up some parsley just because I really like the way the freshness of the parsley kind of makes this whole thing pop. And also the parsley in my garden is growing beautifully, so I want to take full advantage. All right, I'm gonna chop this super fine. And then I'm gonna just squeeze a bit of lemon, because whenever I have citrus, I love to just add, whenever I have seafood, I love to put a little bit of citrus in there. So I'm squeezing it upside down to prevent the pits from going in. Bada bing, bada boom. Give it one final mix, and we have tuna salad. So the way I like to serve this or eat this, I mean, really you can do it any way you want, but with crackers is awesome, over a bed of lettuce or arugula. But if you want it in sandwich form, let me show you how we like to do it in our house. So how we like to do it is we like to build a sandwich. Now I'm not gonna lie, I've kind of been snacking because it's so good. But I'm gonna start off with 2 slices of toasted wheat bread, any kind of bread that you want will work. And I like to use arugula because it's nice and peppery, gives a nice bite, which goes really well with the tuna salad. And I just spoon this goodness right on there.
So yummy, so yummy. You can totally add cheese onto here too, but I really don't think it needs it at all. Cause
we're gonna be adding some avocado. And the avocado, you know, always lends just a nice creaminess that also complements the tuna very well. The sprouts. Come on, come on. How can you say no to this? Whether or not you're a tuna lover. Alrighty. Now, we gotta cut it at a diagonal. It wouldn't be a fancy at-home sandwich if it was not from a diagonal, huh? So, every layer just looks so perfect. No matter what, if you don't like tuna, if you like tuna, this is gonna hit the spot for you. Mm-hmm. After school snack, lunch break, just the tuna over a bed of arugula, this is a winner. If you want more recipes like this, please subscribe to the channel. And if you have a recipe for tuna that you love, please let me know down below. I'm willing to experiment and explore. You know, we all have different taste buds, but this combination really works, so I hope you give it a try. The full ingredient list and directions will be down below in the description box, as well as on my blog. And we'll see you next time on The Bite. You have to try this, just try it.